All right, guys, I'm going to remove some of this because we're going to be discussing more about variables in this video. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use one variable called myAge, and the first thing I'm going to do is print it out. So myAge is, and then I'm going to put a space and a plus, and I'm going to print myAge. And then I'm going to drop down here, and you can reassign values to variables. Now, to do this, you don't just type out the entire thing again, because what it's going to try and do is create a new variable, and there's already one created, and we don't want to do that, and that's a great way to cause, I guess, excessive RAM usage by creating more variables and objects that you need. What we're going to do is we're going to reassign it just by saying my age, just the variable name equals 29. And then I'm going to console log my age next year will be this. Now I'm going to save it. And so what we're doing is we're creating a string and we're adding an integer to it, which makes the integer become a string as well. And this is called concatenation. You can also do this with just two strings. If I wanted to write, you know, hard coded in there, this would print out as my age next year will be 29. But for the purpose of this video, we're learning about reassigning values. So I'm going to set that to my age. I'm going to save it and refresh. And it says my age is 28. Then the variable gets reassigned and it says my age next year will be 29. Now another way to do this would just be adding 1 to my age. So this is a bit of math. What we can do is my age plus 1. I'm going to save it. Now what happens here is the same thing. It says my age next year will be 29 because it takes my age and it adds 1 to it. Now, if we only want to add 1 to it, we can use an extremely shorthand version and say my age plus plus. Save it and refresh. And it didn't change it. And that's because I stored it in there itself. So save it. And there we go. So basically what this is, you don't even need to write the equal sign or anything. This just increases the number by 1. This is actually a feature that was first introduced into C++, and that's why it's called C++, actually, because this was an awesome feature to be added to it. Well, that's not why it was called C++, but it's fitting that C++ was, as far as I know, is the first language to do this. So that's how to increase a number just by 1. You can also do the same thing in reverse by negative, negative. So let's change that to my age last year would be 27. And so if you're using integers and you want a quick way of you know, modifying the value by 1, you're going to use those. Otherwise, you can set my age plus equals 2. I'm going to save it. And refresh. And what plus equals does, this right here is essentially the same as writing my age equals my age plus 2. So it's, you can see what's happening, I hope. Rather than writing the entire thing out like this, my age plus equals knows that we're going to be adding to this directly and storing it in its own variable when we're all done adding to it. So my age now would become 30. So that's a bit more about variables. We need to discuss, I mean, you can do the same thing with text variables. So create a variable called my name. And I'm going to just do that. You can actually declare variables without even assigning a value to it. So this is just an empty variable. And if we try to use it, I'm just going to change this one right here to my name is my name. Save it and refresh. I forgot the plus sign there. Save it and refresh. And it says my name is undefined. And that's literally because we have not defined it yet. By declaring it or assigning a value, you're defining the variable. You're telling the variable what it is. And without that, it is undefined. Which we'll be using some if conditions. We're going to be able to test if something is or is not. And we're going to be learning about that soon, but not right now. So let's go ahead and in the next video, let's cover another type, which is true and false.